Dear colleagues, as you all know, we are right in the heart of a period plagued by the COVID-19 pandemic. And in light of the important emerging impacts on the health and livelihoods of communities, there are important issues that need to be seriously considered. This period is marked by a strong sense of insecurity and an unpredictable future. At Africa Rice, the Executive and Management Committee and I have taken necessary measures to ensure business continuity. We started off by establishing and implementing a home office policy in March 2020, with the main objective of reducing the risk of contamination in our offices. When we were assured that the propagation of the virus could be reduced by establishing and observing physical distancing and respecting good hygiene habits, we then decided in July 2020 that we could resume normal working hours. Policy still applies. However, for vulnerable staff as well as quarantine colleagues in countries where governments still impose these measures, we do not expect staff to take the rules of procedures on preventive measures for COVID-19 for granted. In fact, this has motivated me to take this initiative of talking to all of you, valiant staff of Africa Rice, to remind you of the key measures that were established to reduce and even prevent the spread of the virus. Keep a distance of 2 meters minimum between yourself and other people. Please use a mask in public areas, inside and outside the office. In the staff transport, in your office when you're not alone, and when you leave your office and are moving around the office premises. Whenever you're supposed to use a mask, make sure that it is used correctly. You should cover your nose and your mouth. When using reusable masks, make sure they are washed and disinfected regularly. Disposable masks should be binned after usage. Do not eat or drink in public areas and transport. Wash your hands regularly with soap and water, and in the process, rub them for at least 30 seconds. When you're not in a position to wash your hands, disinfect them with hydroalcoholic solutions. Avoid touching your face, eyes, nose, and mouth, especially when your hands are not washed. Avoid contact with people who are sick or show symptoms of the disease, such as cough, cold, or flu. Cough or sneeze into the crease of your elbow or into a disposable tissue, which should be thrown away after use. Should any one of you or any member of your family you're living with show clear symptoms of COVID-19 or fall sick, do not hesitate to call the official numbers which have been provided to you. In case of assumed COVID-19 infection, you should stay in quarantine for at least 7 days. Please inform your immediate supervisor and your COVID-19 focal point, and in this regard, the designated focal points in our outreach station are as follows: Maimuna Jata in Abidjan, Maimuna Watara in Bouake, Jean Morera in Liberia, Harisua Zanamalala in Madagascar, Vimal Kumar in Nigeria, Sule Sambaba in Senegal, and Edgar Twine in Uganda. In conclusion, I would like to reiterate the importance of strictly observing the COVID-19 preventive measures. COVID-19 is indeed a reality. COVID-19 has a high contamination and mortality rate. I am therefore inviting each and every one of you to respect the hygiene measures, physical distancing rules, and do not forget to wear your mask. When you do, it should cover your nose and your mouth. We encourage each of you to respect these instructions in order to reduce the risk of contamination that eventually could easily be a threat to our health and lives. We also encourage each of you to strictly respect these instructions in order to prevent your colleagues, friends, and beloved ones from being contaminated. Together, this is the only way we can for now break the chain of propagation. Thanks for your attention and stay safe.